Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the press conference of Ukrainian national team. The head coach Andriy Shevchenko and our player Oleksandr Zinchenko. Please raise your hand so we can see that you have a question. We will start with Andriy Shevchenko. Good evening. We understand clearly what team we will be playing against tomorrow. I think it's one of the best teams. At this Euro, it is one of the most balanced teams. They have amazing players. And I would like to notice the work of the head coach, my colleague Gareth Southgate, who indeed gathered amazing group and the team that plays modern football. I think that in England is one of the best moments in its history now. English football is going up now. We saw amazing final of the Champions League, Man City and Chelsea. There's how much speed they had, their performance. Tomorrow will be the most hardest game for us with a very strong opponent. Please, Mikola Ryshnyuk. Please ask your question. Hello, question to the coach. So before the game, a lot of experts from the English team, they say that they have the easiest rival for tomorrow. What do you think about such statements? Is your pride hurt? Is your pride hurt about it? Well, I said before, we totally understand what team we will be playing against, but we also know our strong side. We showed already our character at this tournament, we showed the principles of our game, and we will never change them. And first of all, it is the basis for our team. I know how difficult that game will be for us, but I know that our players have character, and we will try to show it tomorrow.
Okay, Arilas Oldsada from Norway, please ask your question.
A question for Zinchenko, please. This year you've won the Premier League, you played the Champions League final, and you are in the quarterfinal of the Euro. Maybe you don't think about this every day, but it's a good moment to maybe reflect on the path you've had since 2014, for example, where it didn't seem very likely that you would have this fantastic career that you've been having. What's been the most important thing for you on your way to the place you're at right now?
Я прошу прощения, на самом деле перевод не слишком, я думаю, правильный. Можно ли просто услышать этот вопрос просто на английском языке? Потому что я не совсем понял вопрос.
The question was not really understood. Yeah, can you repeat the question, please?
We want to hear you again, please, Arilas.
Sorry. You've had quite an unlikely way from 2014, where you lived in Moscow, and this year, where you are playing the quarterfinal in the Euros, you have won the Premier League, you play the final in the Champions League. Can you reflect on your journey from 2014 to today?
I think that every footballer who is at the stage of the tournament, as I am now, they went through a very big journey. Of course, before I will be going to the pitch tomorrow, I will be thinking about that journey that I had to get here. And of course, I will feel a lot of responsibility because every footballer represents their country. And I have said before that for me it's a massive honor to wear Ukrainian kit.
Please ask a question. Yes, Guido, please.
Buonasera, volevo fare una domanda a Shevchenko.
I wanted to ask a question to Andriy Shevchenko. Good evening, Sheva. I wanted to ask you the following.
If it's possible to not translate, the coach understand Italian, but he will answer on Ukrainian. So please not translate the journalists. Please, Guido De Carolis, ask your question in Italian again, please. Okay, maybe he is not in the stream. Just once more. So Guido, you now on air, so please ask your question.
I wanted to ask Sheva whether the fact that there won't be too many fans in the stadium tonight, and almost no fans from England, and it seems that way as well from Ukraine, based on the numbers in the pandemic, the fact that there are very few England supporters, could that actually help Ukraine or not? Or would it not change anything?
Sicuramente non fa bene per il calcio, però capiamo la situazione.
Clearly that doesn't help football, but we're well aware of the situation with regards to COVID-19 and the restrictions and those that are ongoing.
Che noi abbiamo qua in Italia una grossa comunità dell'Ucraina che
viene. However, we do have a significant Ukrainian community here in Italy, and we hope they'll be at the stadium tomorrow night. And in fact, I invite them, I encourage them to come to the Stadio Olimpico to get behind the team. And I also expect Italian fans to come to the stadium, and I hope they can get behind Ukraine as well.
Так, Андрію, будь ласка.
Доброго дня. Я маю питання до Андрія Миколайовича. Чи ви можете дати стан гравців, які були травмовані у попередньому матчі, як Ярмоленко?
Can you please explain the state of the players who were injured in a previous game, and what with regards to Zubkov, will he be able to play? Yarmolenko is good. He will be getting ready for the game. With regards to Zubkov, he is training individually. We are following his progress.
Okay, Duncan Wright, please ask your question. Okay.
Andrey, first, you mentioned about the Italian fans supporting Ukraine. Do you think the whole of Europe would want Ukraine to beat England at the moment? And a question for Zinchenko. England haven't conceded yet this tournament. You know two of the defenders very well in Kyle and John Stones. How do you go about beating them? What are their weaknesses? Thank you.
Я думаю, что Украина...
I think that Ukraine deserves, first of all, the sympathy from the fans for how well they play, how well they try at this tournament. I hope that such attitude will turn into the fact that maybe more fans will support Ukraine. But I'm more than sure that England showed already great football, and they also have a lot of fans. So tomorrow at the stadium we will see who will support whom better. And I will say that numbers speak for themselves. The fact that England hasn't missed any goals yet, they play very well in defense. But I think that there are no perfect teams. Every team has weaknesses. And with regards to Walker and Stones, they played amazing season, and during the last couple of years I've been playing with them, they play very high level. It will not be easy, we know it. But at this stage of the tournament, everything is possible. And I think that the coaching team, they will explain us what to do with it, and we will do our best. We will try to surprise them, but of course we realize that to get through all the players and the whole team, they will need to play probably the best game of their lives. Do you have any more questions, please? That's the last call for the questions, but we don't see any more hands raised. Thank you all very much. Thank you for the coach and to the player.